Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first episode of FBA Beginner's Guide 101. Through these episodes, we're actually going to be breaking down and going through Amazon FBA as a whole, going through different episodes, finding out what FBA is, how to start, how to get products, what format you need to follow, and just kind of help you out through the journey if you do want to start and actually see if it's worth it. Because I've started this for a few months now, I've made mistakes, I've learned, and now I know exactly what I'm doing. And I want to give you guys kind of a shortcut and understanding of what to do and what to expect, so you guys don't make the full amount of mistakes that I did, but learn from them. So if you like the concept of the series and you want to see more, hit the like button down below, and then obviously comment on what kind of episodes you want to see. Also subscribe. Subscribing is quite important, I need to remember that. So let's start off with the basics. What is Amazon FBA? Amazon FBA stands for Fulfillment by Amazon, and it's whereby you get products for cheap and you ship them up to Amazon. Amazon then deals with listing the product, selling it, shipping out to customers, and dealing with any returns, complaints, or customer service if there is any. Sounds simple, right? There is another business model that Amazon do. It's called Amazon FBM, Fulfillment by Merchant. Very similar. You buy the products, you list them on Amazon, but you deal with shipping out products to customers and then dealing with customer service and or returns. Two different things, right? FBA is literally a lucrative business model. Like when I first looked at it and when I started doing it, it's insane how much money you could just make through the comfort of your own home. It sounds simple. There is a lot of graft, a lot of time and effort that should be put into it, regardless, like anything. But it's actually insane. It's a crazy, crazy business model because you don't even need a lot of capital to start up with. Speaking of capital, what I would advise if you're going to be going on this journey, minimum £1,000, minimum £1,000. £500 is doable, but minimum, if you can, £1,000. Work a bit, ask your mom, ask your dad, ask family, friends, brothers, sisters, if you can borrow some money to start off with, if you need a bit more extra. But £1,000 is definitely a reasonable amount to start off with. So back to the concept, Amazon FBA, Fulfillment by Amazon. Now that you know what kind of the basics of it is, let's break it down. Let's say you find this water bottle. Let's say it's on sale at, I don't know, Wilco for £2. Let's say it's selling on Amazon for 10 quid. You with me? Most of the time there'll be a barcode on it, right? So you open up your app. I personally use Profitall. If you want to check out Profitall, check out the link down below in the description. You get 5% off if you sign up for the yearly plan. But you scan the barcode. There is no barcode on this, so I'm going to look silly doing this. Got some foundation sitting here which I need to send off. But yeah, let's scan that. Type in how much it's selling for, £5. How much you bought it for, £5. Nice. And the app literally breaks it down for you exactly to how much profit you'd be making. So that thing that I just scanned, it's selling right now on Amazon for £14.90. If I bought it for £5, I would be making a profit of £5.17, 103% return on investment, which is pretty impressive, right? So if I bought 10 of those, I'd make 50 quid. For what? Just buying something, sending it off to Amazon, which literally takes no time at all because UPS come and collect it. You don't have to go out and ship it. And you just made 50 quid. For the comfort of your own house. Now that sounds all like a fairy tale, and that's what most people online would tell you, but that does come with hard work, dedication, and you're not gonna be getting that 50 quid instant. That 50 quid can take 2-3 weeks possibly, and that's if you sell your unit. And now that's not to dishearten you, that's just to give you a reality of FBA, because you can't put all your eggs in one basket. You gotta split up and find different products that sell well. The objective is to then send them to Amazon, and in hope that you found good products, they will eventually sell out. It doesn't happen overnight, it takes time. That's just to give you an indication of how much you can make. Like for example, I shipped out some units last week, already 4 sold, and I made 100 quid. Amazon pay on a bi-weekly basis, so I'm not gonna be getting that instantly, but it's coming to my account soon. And of course, on the basis of honesty, that's not a profit, that's revenue, because when you calculate for a business term, you look at the revenue, the total cost of how much the unit cost you, plus how much profit you made on it. But even if you take that away, what? I probably made like 40, 50 pounds profit. Not bad, right? Let's talk about initial startup costs with that as well. So that's basically how much you could possibly make, but there is cost to it. When you sign up to Amazon FBA, there's actually two formats, individual and professional. Individual is free. You don't have to pay anything. Amazon will obviously take their standard fees per item you list, but because it's a free sign up, they will take an additional 75p or 99 European cents on top of every product you sell. So at that example that I gave earlier, if you sell 10 of those on individual, Alexa, what's 10 times 75?
£7.50.
What am I on about? So they'll take an additional £7.50 on that value. So instead of you getting 50, you get 42.50. You with me? Which is still not bad, but when you get to a stage where you're sending a lot of units in, that does add up. So if you're sending like around 30 to 35 units, if you're selling that much a month, something to avoid. The other structure is a professional account. Now, if this costs, it's not free, it's a monthly subscription cost, but they only just take their standard commission fees per the item you sell. This is really good if you're selling a lot of units per the month. And initially, I would always suggest to sign up for that premium. Why? Something we're probably gonna get into another episode is basically gated and ungated. What that means is items locked and you have no ability or eligibility in this case to sell those products on your account. Amazon is very, very funny and fussy with these kind of things, but usually on an individual account, you're gonna have a lot of restrictions put against you. So if you do a professional account, it's easier to get unlocked on things and you've got a wider range of listings. Now, I see a lot of people saying that it costs £25 to sign up for this. It does not. Those people are discluding the VAT. It costs £30 to sign up because you have to add the VAT, 20%. So £30 a month is going to be coming out of your account automatically just on the basics of registering with Amazon and gaining on that platform. You're probably thinking, why am I spending money before I've ever made anything? Because you've got to spend money to make money. Now think of it like this. Okay, 30 quid a month. You've sold those 10 makeups, 50 minus that 20 quid profit. Now imagine if you sell another 10, another 10, another 10. You're going to make money. Because like I said, initially, it's about buying as many as you can and selling them all for profit. 30 quid a month is literally nothing. Alexa, what's 30 divided by 4?
7.5.
£7.50 a week. Are you mad? That's nothing, bro. Alexa, what's 7.5 divided by 7?
7.5 divided by 7 is approximately 1.0714.
Thanks, babe. That's basically a pound a day. Pound a day keeps Amazon FBA at bay. I can't believe I had to calculate 7.5 divided by 7. I could have rounded that up to 7 in the 7 days in a week. What is wrong with me? You're getting financial information from me, so you're watching this video, so what's wrong with you? Now I'm joking, it's just one of those days. I had a brain bar. Brain bar? Brain fart. Brain bath. But you get what I mean. The concept is 30 quid a month is nothing because you can make that back, literally. If you told me there was a business model where you can make profit and all you have to do was invest 30 quid at the start, I'll be like, sign me up. But yeah, that's generally the scope of the basics. I don't want to dwell into it too much because that's what future videos are going to be about. We're going to be trying getting into retail, online, wholesale, private label, how to get product, how to get ungated on products as well, which is very, very vital. So we've got a lot coming. If there's other things that you want to see in this context and in these kind of videos, leave those ideas in the comment section down below and then I can see them and then probably make an episode on them. But with that said, that's it for this video. If you guys did enjoy, hit the like button, subscribe if you're new around here, and I'll catch you a lot in my next one.